Hey guys, welcome back to the Just Minecraft YouTube channel. I am designer Kanika Jain, and in this video we are going to make transfer me coasters. But before moving forward, make sure you subscribe to our channel and turn on the bell notification so you don't miss any update from us. So let's get started. So here I'm using MDF coasters, and you can see that's how I'm going to paint and show that how these look. So here I have taken pale yellow chalk paint and baby blue chalk paint, and using my flat brush I'm going to apply a layer on the base. And as these are the light shades, so what you can do is you can as well apply two layers of the chalk paints for a neat finish. So firstly, I'm going to cover the background like this, and I'm going to color blend both the colors so that where the color is blending somewhere it would give a green shade. And don't worry about the brush strokes which are visible. Once you are done with the layer 1, after you do layer 2, they won't be visible. And you know, these days it's so easy to create your projects using TransferMe, so I thought to make coasters and share tutorial with you all. So just in case if you're liking, don't forget to hit the like button. So now here I'm going to show you second technique. So what I'm going to do here is I'm taking up the pale yellow chalk paint and covering a little more than half of my coaster with this color only, and on the lower part I'm going to cover with the blue chalk paint, and in the middle I'm going to blend both of these color. So this will give a very nice background look once I do the transfer me, which you can already see here. And now I'll do a second layer as well. And meanwhile these will get dried up, I'll just fussy cut my transfer me sheets, which I'm going to show later in this video as well. And today as well I'm going to show, if you want to do your bulk order, so how you can multitask and create coasters or any projects. So here I'm taking this transfer me sheet. This is Vintage Styles #1. You can check out the link in the description box as well. And the second sheet which I'm going to use is this lace collection, and I'm going to blend both of these. But before that, I'm going to fussy cut. Firstly, I'm going to fussy cut it like this and take out the elements which I want to place on my coasters. That's how I start working with my transfer me sheets, and then later on do the intricate fussy cutting, which I'm going to teach you later in this video as well. And I wanted to ask, have you worked with these amazing transfer me sheets? Do comment and let me know what all projects have you created using these transfer me sheets. I am looking forward to hear from you. So here I am using my fussy cutting scissors, and here you can see I am simply doing the intricate fussy cutting, and similarly I'll do with all of the elements. The first and the foremost reason is that this will give a very nice finished look to my coaster. And what I'm going to do here is I'm just leaving 1mm or 2mm border so that no one will ever recognize that you have done it by yourself. It looks as amazing. Trust me, once I complete with the projects, you must watch this full video and see how these look at the end of this video. So that's how I have fussy cut my elements, and these are as well done. And here you can see everything is ready. And similarly, I'm going to fussy cut the lace collection as well. So here I'm just taking this one strip, and I'll tell you how you can multi-use this. And now let's start and let the magic begin of transfer me. So here you can see the coasters are dried as well, and now I'm going to place over these transfer me sheets. So here I have taken a bowl of water and as well a sponge. So here I'm just starting off, and what I'm going to do is, first of all, I'm going to peel off this transparent film which is present, and this saves your transfers as well. And I'm going to place over this on the left hand side. So that's, I'm doing it willingly. If you want to add just one element, so you can as well place the transfer at the center.
And now I'm dabbing off a little bit of water using my sponge. And once you can see like here, the top film goes little translucent. So when you can see the image getting seen by your naked eyes, you know that it's time for the magic and we can remove off the transfer. Like here, I'm removing the excess water and now simply I'll slide it down like this. And voila, our transfer is done. Now I will just let it dry and work on my next coaster, and now I'll show that how you can multitask and create multiple coasters at one go itself. So I'm just repeating the same process like how I did earlier. Now I'm going to show that how you can multitask and create multiple coasters within one go. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just dabbing a little bit of water onto this and I will set this aside once I'm done dabbing off the water, and I'll take my third coaster and peel off the layer and place it over on my third coaster, and I'll add a little bit of water to this one as well. Please see, I'm not adding a lot of water and I'm just letting this dry, and meanwhile I'll go back to my second coaster. And now I'll just remove the excess water and simply peel off, and you can see my second coaster is done, and meanwhile my third coaster is as well almost ready, and I can remove the top layer of this as well. So that's how I work, and whenever I have to do multiple transfers at the same time, I use this technique, and I hope you as well like this technique, and this will save a lot of your time. Trust me, it will save a lot of your time. Meanwhile, I'll leave first three to dry and I'll complete the fourth coaster as well. Meanwhile, I will set this aside to soak in the water, and I'll take my lace and I'll place it over like this, and I'll mark it using my fingers and cut it down. So the reason I used the earlier motif on the left hand side was this only, that I wanted to add this lace here, and now here I'm chipping off the excess transfer me and I'm going to remove the film of the fourth one, and you can see this is ready as well. Now I will leave this to dry and go back to my earlier coasters, and similarly I have added the layer on both of them and I'm going to work together. So that's another way of completing your projects at the same time, and I'm making sure that I don't overdo with the water as I have a transfer me on the left hand side of this coaster as well. Now I'll keep these aside for 15-20 minutes, and after that here I'm using the Cadence Aqua Stone Varnish. You can find out the link in the description box, and as well I'm using a flat brush, and I'm going to apply the varnish directly on my coaster. And what I do is I keep one brush separately just for the sake of applying varnish, and I like to apply varnish in one go itself, like in one stroke as well, and I don't like to put in the varnish earlier on my nonstick craft mat. I directly add on the varnish on my project and then spread it out evenly. Make sure you're spreading out the varnish evenly and as well covering the sides of your coaster. And once I am done with layer one, what I do is I keep these to dry for about an hour or so, and then I make sure that I apply a second layer of the same varnish as well. And here I mistakenly added a lot of varnish, so you will see me removing the excess varnish and adding it on the fourth coaster so that I can reuse it while I do apply the varnish on the fourth coaster. And now I'll just simply let these dry, and here I'm going to apply the layer of varnish on my fourth coaster, and after an hour I'm going to apply second layer of this same varnish. Varnish plays an important role on transfer me sheets, so I would highly recommend you to use a good quality varnish, and my personal favorite is this one. And that's how my coasters look. at the final go. And I hope you enjoyed watching this tutorial. I hope to see you soon. Until next time, till then, happy crafting.